So, in this class, we are going to solve the questions from JEE Mains September 2020, and the questions are from limits. So, already we discussed many concepts and many standard limits, formulas, logics, and different things related to the limits in the regular class. Okay? And all those things are completed. So, now we are going to solve these questions. So, now at present, I have two questions. One question is question from September 2nd morning paper. And the other question is from September 2nd evening paper. Then I will give you questions from September 3rd and then like that. First of all, think about this question which is asked in September 2022 morning session. Okay? Now, when you look at this problem, see limit extends to 1, x plus x square plus and so on plus x power m minus n divided by x minus 1 is equals to 820. Then we need to find the values of m, value of m. See, there are different ways to solve the problem. One way is using the standard limits. Okay? Just you split this n as n ones. Okay? Write it like 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus like that and attach to each and every term. Then use standard limit. That is one way. In another way, simply I will use L'Hospital rule. And before going to apply L'Hospital rule, whether is there any possibility to apply that or not, I need to check. Whenever we need to use L'Hospital rule, see, if direct substitution gives you either 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity, then only the problem allows us to use L'Hospital rule. First of all, check it by the direct substitution. When you directly replace x with 1, you will get that 1 plus 1 square plus and so on plus 1 power n minus n divided by 1 minus 1. See, 1 plus 1 square plus and so on plus 1 power n. So, all these are 1s. See, since there are n terms, sum of n ones is n minus n is 0 and the denominator is 0, 0 by 0. Since it is 0 by 0, now you are allowed to use L'Hospital rule. Okay? For some time, leave about that 820, think about this problem. Now use L'Hospital rule. So according to L'Hospital rule, this limit value is equals to limit extends to 1. Since we are using L'Hospital's rule, okay? You need to apply derivative for numerator and denominator. Derivative of x is 1. Okay? And derivative of x square is 2x. And then derivative of x cube is 3x square plus and so on plus derivative of x power n is n x power n minus 1. Starting from x to x power n, just I am applying derivative. And for this n, the derivative is 0 divided by derivative of x is 1 and the derivative of minus 1 is 0, leave it, no problem. Now, just by applying L'Hospital rule once, the problem will become like this. So, according to that L'Hospital rule, the limit values of these two are equal. Now, to calculate this limit value, substitute x is equals to 1 directly. You will get that 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on plus n. So, if you replace x with 1, so you will get the sum of first n natural numbers. And we know sum of first n natural numbers is simply n into n plus 1 by 2. This value is given as 820 and they ask us to find n value. So therefore, n into n plus 1 by 2 is equals to 820. And we need to calculate the value. Okay? One way is moving from the options or the other way, you just directly calculate it. Okay? How can we calculate? So you just take it as n into n plus 1 is 820, right? You just try to express it, see n into n plus 1, okay? 820, okay? This is 820 into 2. Or otherwise, when you go from the options, okay? Yeah, if n is equals to some 40, so 40 into 41 is this particular value. Or otherwise, 40 into 41 by 2 is 820. You just check it. Okay? 40 by 2 is 20. 20 into 41 is 820. So at the end, you will get that n value as 40. Okay? Just have a look. Actually, this is numerical value type question. Okay? So you don't have options. You just factorize it, then also you will get that 40 as your answer. Okay? 820 into 2, right? So you just write it like 82 into 20. So 82 into 20 is one possibility. and then send one more to that side. So if you divide with 2, you will get it as 41 and send to that side, that is 40. So n into n plus 1 is 40, 1 into 40, then the value of n is equals to 40. Okay. So this is a numerical value type question from September 2nd morning paper. Okay. And your value of n is 40. Then think about the first problem, which is question from September 2nd evening session. Okay. So what is the problem? Limit x tends to 0 tan of pi by 4 plus x to the power 1 by x. So first of all, you just go with direct substitution. When you go with direct substitution, see, the direct substitution is giving like this: tan of pi by 4 plus 0 to the power 1 by 0. Right, tan of pi by 4 is what? 1. So 1 power 1 by 0 is infinity. So the value is 1 power infinity. See, direct substitution is giving 1 power infinity. This is indeterminate. So to avoid this indeterminate form, as we discussed in the previous class, we need to write it like this. This is equals to e power limit x tends to 0 base minus 1. Okay, what is the base here? Tan of pi by 4 plus x. Subtract 1 from that. This is base minus 1. Okay, into that g of x, 1 by x. So since it is 1 power infinity format, to avoid that, we followed certain logic with the series. From there we conclude, we have an idea that this limit value is equals to this limit. E power limit x tends to 0, this base minus 1 into the power. So now we need to solve this. This is equals to e power limit x tends to 0 tan of pi by 4 plus x. So tan of 45 plus theta. Simply use tan of a plus b. Tan A plus tan B by 1 minus tan A tan B. From there, tan of pi by 4 plus x is 1 plus tan x by 1 minus tan x minus 1 into 1 by x. You just try to simplify in the bracket. If we simplify in the bracket, we will get it as like this: e power limit x tends to 0 in the bracket minus 1 and plus tan x by 1 minus tan x. 1 and 1 will get cancelled. You left that 2 tan x by 1 minus tan x into 1 by x. Simply you just think about this limit x tends to 0. Okay, this is equals to e power limit x tends to 0 2 tan x by 1 minus tan x into 1 by x. You just rewrite in such a way: 2 into tan x by x into 1 minus tan x. And we have an idea that as x is tending to 0, tan x by x value is 1. So this particular tan x by x value is 1. And as x is tending to 0, replace x with 0. Tan 0 is 0. So this value is e power 2 into 1 into 1 by 1 minus 0. And on simplification, our answer is e square. Okay. So this is the question from September 2nd evening from limits. Okay. Have a look. I will give you next two questions which are asked in September 3rd morning and evening. So now just look at the problems. So we have two questions. One is September 3rd evening question and the other one is September 3rd morning question from the limits. See, just look at this particular problem. Limit x tends to a plus 2x to the power 1 by 3 minus 3x power 1 by 3 divided by 3a plus x to the power 1 by 3 minus 4x to the power 1 by 3. This value we need to find. If you replace directly x with a, it is again giving 0 by 0 indeterminate form. So to avoid that indeterminate form, either we may go with the standard limits or we may go with the L'Hospital rule, because it is 0 by 0. See, converting the given problem into standard limit format is also a bit complicated. So that's why my idea is to move with the L'Hospital rule. Okay. Since it is indeterminate form, so better to use L'Hospital rule. But before going to use L'Hospital rule, according to the rule, we need to apply derivative for the numerator and denominator. So what will be the derivative of this? Okay. For suppose if you have a function like some capital X to the power 1 by 3, its derivative is simply nothing but the power 1 by 3 into x to the power 1 by 3 minus 1. Just like x power n, n into x power n minus 1 into derivative of that capital X with respect to small x. that is the derivative of that x power only 2. So now according to that, see, limit x tends to a, I think you all aware about the derivatives for some basic functions. This is a plus 2x to the power 1 by 3, so I can write it like this: 1 by 3 into a plus 2x to the power 1 by 3 minus 1. So actually I need to write 1 by 3 minus 1. What is that 1 by 3 minus 1? Minus 2 by 3 into derivative of this a plus 2x into the derivative of this base. We need to mention for a it is 0, for 2x it is 2 minus. So now this is 3x to the power 1 by 3. So again 1 by 3 into 3x to the power minus 2 by 3 into derivative of 3x is 3, and the whole thing is divided by 3a plus x to the power 1 by 3. The same logic, 1 by 3 into 3a plus x to the power minus 2 by 3 into derivative of this bracket. For 3a the derivative is 0, for x the derivative is 1, minus 4x to the power 1 by 3. 1 by 3 into 4x to the power minus 2 by 3 into the derivative of 4x is 4. Simply applying derivative for numerator and denominator by L'Hospital rule, and we need to know that there a way of applying derivative for the some basic functions. Now just replace x with a. One thing I will do, see, 1 by 3 1 by 3 1 by 3 1 by 3, so it is better to cancel out that 1 by 3 by just common out that 1 by 3 and then cancel it out and then replace x with a. Okay, what we are getting, just have a look, this is equals to, if you replace x with a, what will happen? 2a plus a, what it is? 3a power minus 2 by 3, and we have 2 here. Okay, so 2 into 3a to the power minus 2 by 3 minus, just replace x with a here, 3a to the power minus 2 by 3, but this time 3 into, so minus 3 into 3a to the power minus 2 by 3 divided by, replace x with a here, 3a plus a is 4a to the power minus 2 by 3. Okay, this is 4a to the power minus 2 by 3 minus, so 4 into 4a to the power minus 2 by 3, 4 into 4a to the power minus 2 by 3. So this 1 by 3, you just pick it out, this 1 by 3 from these two and cancel it out. And then 2 minus 3 is minus 1, right? So minus 3a to the power minus 2 by 3 divided by, this is 1 into this particular 4a power minus 2 by 3 minus 4 into 4a power minus 2 by 3. So that is minus 3 into 4a to the power minus 2 by 3. So we need to simplify it, we need to calculate it. Okay, so how to calculate this? Just have a look, minus and minus gets cancelled, right? So we left with what? 1 by 3. So and then 3a power minus 2 by 3, 4a power minus 2 by 3. So a power minus 2 by 3, a power minus 2 by 3 gets cancelled. We left with 3 power minus 2 by 3, 4 power minus 2 by 3. Because the power is minus 2 by 3, we have a chance to reciprocal it. So at the end, the answer is this. I will write here. So 1 by 3 into 4 by 3 to the power 2 by 3. Just send that minus, you will get it as 4 by 3. So if you wish, try to simplify it, otherwise this is the answer. Okay, 1 by 3 into 4 by 3 power 2 by 3. Just have a look, okay? Yeah. If you wish, just send this 2 inside. You do some simplification. Finally, your answer is this: 1 by 3 into 4 by 3 power 2 by 3. So our answer is this: 1 by 3 into 4 by 3 power 2 by 3, right? Once again, I explain for you, just instead of applying standard, instead of converting it into standard limit, just directly I am applying L'Hospital rule. So use derivatives. So and then replace x with a. So replacing x with a and then doing simplification. So you just pay some attention, okay? Carefully you just do simplification, and then this is your answer, okay? So in the previous September 2nd questions also, there is one question where we need to use L'Hospital rule. Okay, this is also such question. And see, in some papers, actually in September JE mains is conducted on 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, in these days the exam is conducted. Only we have limits questions from second September 2nd papers and then from September 3rd papers as well as from September 5 papers. Whereas in September 4 and September 6, direct questions from limits are not included. Okay, the questions from limits along with continuity, limits along with differentiation are included. See, I will discuss those questions at that chapter. Okay, and now just look at this particular question. This is also a bit different. Limit extends to 0. Modulus of, see, modulus is there for the complete problem, okay? Modulus of 1 minus x plus mod x divided by lambda minus x plus step x. Here this square bracket indicates step, okay? Actually in the question, they mentioned that the square bracket is the greatest integer function. See, this value is given as L and we need to calculate that L value. See, since modulus is involved, step is involved, so for these type of problems, we need to think about left hand limit as well as the right hand limit. See, thinking about left hand limit in the sense as x is tending to 0 minus. Since x is tending to 0 minus, we know that x less than 0. Since x is less than 0, modulus of x is minus x. And what to say about this step x? See, x value is less than 0. X value is less than 0 in the sense that is in between minus 1 and 0. So its step value is minus 1. So now you just directly think about that limit. So according to that, L is the value, okay, or otherwise for some time you just leave about that L. Limit x tends to 0 modulus of 1 minus x. See, since we are discussing left hand limit, modulus of x can be replaced with minus x, okay, minus x divided by lambda minus x, and step x value is again minus 1, right? So minus 1. So now you just apply x in 0 in the place of x. X and x minus 2x, 0. So this is also 0. So you left with this value as modulus of 1 divided by lambda minus 1. So the left hand limit is modulus of lambda minus 1. Okay. Now I am thinking about the right hand limit. So to find the right hand limit as x is tending to 0 plus. As x is tending to 0 plus, x is greater than 0. Since x is greater than 0, modulus of x is equals to x. And what to say about step x? X value is more than 0, so its step value is 0 simply. Replace that mod x and step x with this x and 0 in the problem. Then the problem is limit x tends to 0, modulus of 1 minus x plus x divided by lambda minus x plus 0. Just have a look. See, this minus x and plus x gets cancelled. And then as x is tending to 0, replace x with 0, you will get your answer as 1 by lambda. So the left hand limit is this 1 by lambda minus 1, right hand limit is that 1 by lambda along with the modulus. As they mentioned, limit value exists, that in essence left hand limit is equals to right hand limit. Okay. So for that, you need to take that modulus of lambda minus 1 is equals to modulus of lambda. Since these two are equal, the denominators are also equal. Modulus of lambda minus 1 is equals to modulus of lambda. So lambda minus 1 is equals to lambda or minus lambda. See, lambda minus 1 is equals to lambda is a wrong idea. So lambda minus 1 is equals to minus lambda. From there you will get that lambda is equals to 1 by 2. Since lambda is equals to 1 by 2, you just replace lambda value as 1 by 2 here, you will get it as 2. And replace lambda 1 by 2 here, again you will get 2. That in the sense left limit is 2, right limit is 2, so our limit value is 2 and that L is 2. So answer for this problem is 2. The problem is simple, but we need to solve the problem using left hand limit as well as right hand limit. And while calculating left and right limits, you need to think about modulus and step in both the cases. Have a look. Your answer at the end is 2. So next questions, okay. As I said, there are no questions directly from limits and 4th exam papers, okay, as well from 6th exam paper also. Now these are two questions from 5th exam papers. This is September 5th morning exam paper question and this is September 5th evening exam paper question. Think about the question. See, as they mentioned, alpha is a positive root of this polynomial p of x is equals to x square minus x minus 2 is equals to 0, and we need to calculate this particular limit value. And one thing is here very clear, see, there is a chance to find the roots for this polynomial. Since it is x square minus x minus 2, you just write it like x minus 2 into x plus 1 is equals to 0. So the values of x are 2 or minus 1, right? Since they are 2 or minus 1, as they said alpha is a positive root of the polynomial, so you just take that alpha is equals to 2. That was clear. And now if you replace alpha 2 here, then the problem will become limit x tends to 2 plus square root of this 1 minus cos p of x can be written as 2 sin square p of x by 2. 1 minus cos theta is 2 sin square theta by 2 divided by x, replace alpha with 2. 2 minus 4 is minus 2 divided by x minus 2. Okay, and now we need to solve this particular problem. Limit x tends to 2 plus square root of 2 sin square p of x by 2 and divided by x by 2. And now this polynomial has two roots. Okay, what are the roots? 2 and minus 1. This is simply x minus 2 into x plus 1, right? So from there it is very clear that we have a chance to rewrite p of x as x minus 2 into x plus 1. This p of x is simply x minus 2 into x plus 1, and the roots are 2 minus 1, 1 root is 2. That's why the problem, I wrote the problem in this way. Now what I do is, since the denominator is x minus 2, right, whereas p of x is x minus 2 into x plus 1, that's why what I do is I just write this x minus 2, I just multiply with x plus 1 and divide with x plus 1, both numerator and denominator. Okay, this into x plus 1 divided by x plus 1. Why? Because I am trying to make p of x in the denominator. Okay, then how the problem will become? So for the space I am erasing this and then I will solve it. Okay, you just have a look. Now this is equals to limit x tends to 2 plus root of 2 sin square p of x by 2, root 2 into sin modulus of sin p of x divided by 2 into x plus 1 divided by x minus 2 into x plus 1 is p of x. Okay, right? See, square root of sin square is simply modulus of sin p of x by 2, and as x is tending to 2 plus, what we need to say, as x is tending to 2 plus, this polynomial value is what? That polynomial value is approaching to 0 plus. Is it right? As I mentioned you, this polynomial is simply x minus 2 into x plus 1, right? So as x is tending to 2 plus something, it is nearer by 2 and then more than 2. So this value is 0 plus something. Since it is 0 plus something, it comes under first quadrant. This p of x by 2 is 0 plus something. So easily you will remove that modulus sign. And we have p of x. So I need one more 2 here. Divide with 2 and then multiply with 2. Limit x tends to 2 plus. Since it is 2 plus, there is a chance to remove the modulus. So sine of p of x by 2 into x plus 1 divided by p of x by 2 into 2. Now just have a look, as x is tending to 0, p of x is tending to, as x is tending to 2 plus, p of x is tending to 0. So this sine of p of x by 2 by p of x by 2 value is 1, and you just replace 2 in that x plus 1, you will get that root 2 into 2 plus 1 is 3 divided by 2. And on solvation you will get your answer as 3 by root 2. Okay, just have a look, the problem is bit tricky. Okay, at the end your answer is 3 by root 2. Okay, so the problem involves with polynomials along with the limits, and then something you need to know about trigonometry and quadrants, everything, a multi conceptual question. Okay, but the problem is somewhat easy question. Okay, easy to moderate. Have a look. So next question, September 5th evening question. Limit x tends to 0, x into e power root of 1 plus x square plus x power 4 minus 1 by x minus 1 divided by something. You just observe one first, this denominator is equals to this. Okay, and send this x to the denominator, it will become like this. Okay, e power root of 1 plus x square plus x power 4 minus 1 by x minus 1 divided by root of 1 plus x square plus x power 4 minus 1 divided by x. Now it is just looking in the standard format. Okay, as they mentioned, this is limit x tends to 0. So my idea is taking this complete expression as t. So you just take you just take that t is equals to root of 1 plus x square plus x power 4 minus 1 divided by x. As x is tending to 0, what you say about t? And that's why you need to calculate t value as x is tending to 0. Now, limit x tends to 0, what is this particular limit value t? 1 plus x square plus x power 4 minus 1 divided by x. To solve that, what we need to do? To solve that, you just go with the factorization, okay? Yeah, the way of factorization is simply multiplying both numerator and denominator with this root. 1 plus x square plus x power 4 plus 1 divided by root 1 plus x square plus x power 4 plus 1. And if you try to solve this, this is equals to limit x tends to 0. The numerator is a minus b into a plus b. When you apply a square minus b square, this 1 and that 1 square will get cancelled. You left with x square plus x power 4 by x into some bracket. So cancel out 1x and then replace x with 0, still you will get 0 only. So as x is tending to 0, this t value is also tending to 0. And that's why when you convert this total problem in terms of t, so you just take it as t e power t minus 1 by t. And as x is tending to 0, here the discussion is that t is also tending to 0. So limit t tends to 0. So limit t tends to 0, e power t minus 1 by t is a standard limit and its answer is 1. So finally, your answer for the problem is 1. Okay, so these are the questions from main September 2020. And there are some other questions in the remaining papers where the limits are combined with continuity as well as with differentiation. Okay, have a look.